La red social Instagram sigue trabajando para limitar el discurso de odio y racismo. Por eso anunció recientemente una nueva herramienta que le permitirá a sus usuarios estar más seguros. El odio y el racismo no tienen cabida en Instagram, así lo indicó Adam Mosseri, CEO de Instagram, a través de un video. Aseguró que la intención de la compañía es reducir la cantidad de discurso de odio en la red social lo más próximo a cero que sea posible.
Hi everyone, I've been gone for a few weeks. I was taking a little bit of vacation and a lot happened while I was away. Today I want to talk about the Euros finals and the wave of racism that we saw, particularly in the UK, and the wake of that loss by England. I just want to start by saying that racism and hate speech has no place on Instagram. It is not only honestly fucked up to see people treated that way, but it actually breaks how Instagram works. People need to feel comfortable. They need to feel safe expressing themselves to if they're going to use Instagram and for the whole thing to work. And what we care about here is helping drive culture forward. And culture is disproportionately driven by underrepresented groups, particularly Black communities around the world. And this racism didn't just happen on Instagram, it happened on platforms, on the internet more broadly, and obviously offline as well. But I want to be really clear that we won't stand for it here at Instagram. We know that inevitably some racism is going to happen on the platform. There are racists in the world, and they're not going to check their racism at the door when they open up our app, which is why we think it's so important that we do two things. One is to try and reduce the amount of hate speech on the platform to as close to zero as we possibly can. But the other is to accept that some is inevitably going to happen on the platform, which is why we need to also build tools for the targets of this kind of harassment to protect themselves, to take some power back. And we've got room to improve on both fronts. On detecting racism and hate speech, we're getting better over time. It can be challenging because one word or emoji might be totally benign in one context, but completely abhorrent in another. We also rely on reports, and I want to acknowledge right now that we mistakenly marked a bunch of reports of racist comments as benign, and that's on us. We've since fixed the issue, and we appreciate the feedback. We get millions of reports a day, so if we get 1% of them wrong, that's tens of thousands of problematic things that can be said on Instagram, which is why it is so important that we also build tools to allow people to protect themselves. Block is a tool that's existed for a long time, but another one you might not know about is Restrict, which allows you to take some power back if someone's harassing you. You can approve their comments before anyone else sees them on your content. You can read their messages without sending red receipts. Other things include hidden words, which has allowed you to block certain keywords and comments that you pick for years now, but we've actually recently extended hidden words to cover DMs as well. We're currently experimenting with something we call Limits, which essentially locks down your account when you're in a moment of risk. Maybe you're in high school and you're going through a breakup, or you just switched schools, or maybe you're a professional footballer and you're receiving a lot of harassment. Whatever it is, we know that people sometimes are in temporary moments of real risk and pain, and we want to give them tools to protect themselves in those situations. And so we've got more to do on both fronts. More to do to prevent racism and hate speech from being spread on a platform in the first place, and more to do to build tools that allow the targets of that kind of horrible activity to defend themselves. And so expect to hear from more from us on both fronts in the months to come. And with that, I'm going to sign off and say see you next week.